depression in freezing point of pure solvent. I have already explained when a non-volatile solute is dissolved in a pure solvent, its vapor pressure decreases. That's why boiling point of such a solution is more than the pure solvent. What about freezing point? So in order to discuss this depression in freezing point, first we have to know what is the freezing point. At a freezing point is the temperature. Definition for freezing point. It is the temperature at which, there exists an equilibrium between solid form and liquid form of substance. Solid form and liquid form, there must be an equilibrium. Equilibrium means pressure of vapor pressure of solid. Its meaning is vapor pressure of solid is equal to vapor pressure of liquid. So how to define freezing point? The temperature at which the vapor pressure of solid and liquid forms of a substance are equal, or in another words, the temperature at which there exists an equilibrium between solid form and liquid form of substance is called freezing point. But you know, when a non-volatile solute is dissolved in a pure solvent, its freezing point decreases. Boiling point increases, but freezing point decreases, opposite. This is also because of the reason lowering of vapor pressure. Already I had explained, vapor pressure of a solution containing non-volatile solute is lesser than that of pure solvent. Because of the same reason, here also, freezing point of a solution containing non-volatile solute is always lesser than the pure solvent. The difference, if you take some T naught as a, what is that? T naught is the freezing point of pure solvent, and TS is the freezing point of solution containing non-volatile solute. This T naught is always less than, TS is always less than T naught. So solution will have lesser freezing point than pure solvent. So where T naught is freezing point of pure solvent, and this TS is freezing point of solution containing non-volatile solute. So which is having more freezing point, solvent or solution? Yes, solvent is having, pure solvent is having more freezing point. That's why it's a difference. That means T naught minus TS. T naught minus TS. The difference is called depression of freezing point. Here F stands for freezing. So T naught minus TS is called what? Depression of freezing point. So how to define the depression in freezing point? It is the difference in the freezing points of pure solvent and its solution containing non-volatile solute. Now let's see how an expression for a delta TFO can be derived. Okay, so for that, here also let us draw a graph. Graph between pressure, that means vapor pressure versus temperature. Vapor pressure versus temperature. This is a solid phase, that is liquid phase. If you extend this line to meet the y-axis, it will meet at certain temperature. Let it be P naught, this is P1, this is P2. Here, this line is of pure solvent. Similarly, the second line is of solution 1. Third line is of solution 2. Okay. So, until when the temperature of liquid is decreased? It's when, here when you move from right to left, that indicates what? Temperature is decreasing. So, when you cool the liquid, what happens? At certain temperature, it will be freezed. So, this is the point where the pure solvent freezes. So, until this point, there is liquid. After this point, solid. I have extended the line to meet the y-axis. Similarly, it is solution 1, it is for solution 2. So, from this graph, we can say that solution 2 is more concentrated than solution 1. Why? Vapor pressure of solution 2 is lower. That's why. This is solvent. So, sometimes such type of questions will be given. A graph will be given in that some curves. So, in that graph, which curve represents that of pure solvent? Always the curve, upper curve indicates. Always the upper curve indicates pure solvent. The lower curve indicates, lowest curve indicates highest concentration of solution. Okay, so in that way we can answer if graphs are given. So solution 2 is more concentrated than solution 1 and it is pure solvent. Okay, so solution 1 freezes at this point, solution 2 freezes at this point. Let the freezing point of solution 2 some T2. For solution 1, T1. For pure solvent, T0 or T0. What are T0, T1, T2? T0, T1, T2 are freezing points of pure solvent, less concentrated solution, more concentrated solution respectively. Here also, what is the relation among P0, P1, P2 and T0, T1, T2? See the relation here also, P1 greater than, P1 greater than P2. Freezing point relation, here also see, T2, T0 greater than, T1 greater than T2. Have you seen the difference between boiling points and freezing points? There, if vapor pressure is increased, boiling point decreased. But here, see, vapor pressure, when you go from pure solvent to more concentrated solution, vapor pressure is decreasing. Its freezing point also decreasing. So, freezing point, vapor pressure, they are directly. But boiling point, vapor pressure are inversely. Okay. Now, from this, we can derive an expression for depression of freezing point. What is that expression? See the expression for delta DF. So here we know that let A, this is B, this is C. A, B, C, a triangle. Similarly, A, D, E, this is another triangle. So from these triangles, triangle A, B, C and triangle A, D, E are similar triangles. That's why we can take a relation. Triangle ABC and AD are similar triangles. So there is a relation. What is that relation? AE by AC equal to AE by AC equals to ED by DE by BC. DE by BC. See, what is AE? AE means this portion. It is approximately equal to this portion. So, P0 minus P1, this is AE. Similarly, P naught minus P2, this is AC. That side, DE means this difference. P naught minus T1. Similarly, BC means this difference. That is T naught minus T2. So from this, we can write that delta TB1, delta P1 by P0 minus P1 is nothing but lowering of vapor pressure. Lowering of vapor pressure means delta P. So delta P1, that means lowering of vapor pressure for first solution by second solution. That side, T0 minus T1 is called what? Depression of freezing point for first solution, for second solution. So this is delta TF1 by delta TF2. So from this we can say that delta P is directly proportional to delta TF. Delta P is directly proportional to delta TF. Already we have that. We have that delta P by P naught equals to mole fraction of solute. Take P naught that side. Then delta P equals to P naught into X2. Delta P equals to P naught into X2. That means delta P directly proportional to X2. You know, mole fraction is directly proportional to molality. As delta P directly proportional to molality, delta TF, therefore, delta TF is also directly proportional to molality of the solution. Now expand it. Delta TF is equal to some constant KF into molality. This is the standard equation for depression in the freezing point. See, this equation is similar to that of delta TB. In the elevation and the boiling point, elevation in the boiling point also we got the similar relation. There what did we discuss? Delta TB equals to KB into M, where KB is molar elevation constant. You know, molar elevation constant is also called ebullioscopic constant. What is that? Ebullioscopic constant. Ebullioscopy means it is the study of reactions at high temperature. Here KF is called molar depression constant. Molar depression constant, or also called, this is also called cryoscopic constant. What is that? Cryoscopic constant. What is cryoscopy? Cryoscopy is the study which explains the reactions at a very low temperature. So freezing point is the least temperature for a liquid where it exists. So cryoscopic constant, the word is given for KF. Whereas KB, molar elevation constant, that is called ebullioscopic constant. KF is called what? Cryoscopic constant. This KF depends on solvent. So it is solvent dependent factor. And what are its units? Units of KF. What are its units? It is also M. Here what is M? M is nothing but molality of solution. What are the units for molality? Mole per kg. So this is mole per kg, this is Kelvin. Take mole per kg this side, you will get the units of KF. What are those units? Kelvin, kg, mole inverse. Kelvin, kg, mole inverse. So units of both KB, elevation constant, and KF, depression constant, are same. There in KB also you studied the same units, Kelvin, kg, mole inverse for KB, Kelvin, kg, mole inverse for KF also. See the value of KF for water. For water, its value is 1.86 Kelvin kg mole inverse. Kelvin kg mole inverse, that is Kf value for water. What is Kb value for water? 0.52 Kelvin kg mole inverse. Already I had explained in the elevation of boiling point. Next, what are the parameters we take for calculation of Kf? Kf is equal to, like Kb, Kf also has some thermodynamic expression. Here R Tf square by Lf, Lf into 1000. We can write it as R Tf square into gram molecular weight of solvent by GMW1, means gram molecular weight of solvent, by enthalpy of fusion into 1000. This is the relation. Okay, so RTF square into gram molecular weight 1 by, what are the terms involved in it? TF, where TF is freezing point of pure solvent. It is freezing point of pure solvent, TF is. Similarly, LF, what is this? Latent heat of fusion. Latent heat of fusion. Fusion, freezing are the words same. Value is same, but process is different. Fusion means conversion of solid into liquid, that is fusion. But freezing means conversion of a liquid into solid, that is freezing. So process are different. But fusion temperature, freezing temperature, both are same for the same substance. See, for example, freezing point of water is, freezing point of liquid water is 0 degree centigrade. Similarly, the fusion point, the fusion point or fusion temperature of ice is 0 degree centigrade. So process is different, okay, but the value is same. So LF is latent heat of fusion. Latent heat of fusion means it is the heat required for the conversion of 1 gram of solid form into liquid form. Conversion of 1 gram of solid form into its liquid form is called latent heat of fusion. Its value is enthalpy of a fusion by gram molecular weight of solvent. So what is delta fuse H naught? It is enthalpy of fusion. It is enthalpy of fusion. Enthalpy of fusion means it is also similar like LF. But in LF we take only for 1 gram conversion, here for 1 mole conversion. So what is the definition for enthalpy of fusion? It is the amount of heat required for the conversion of 1 mole of a solid into its liquid form. So for the conversion of 1 mole, we use the word enthalpy of fusion. For the conversion of 1 gram, we use the latent heat of fusion. Okay, in that way they are related. R means gas constant. Any more term to discuss? GMW1 means gram molecular weight of solvent. Okay, so this is Kf. Next, using Kf and molality, molality formula, we know that. What is the formula for molality? In any case, weight of solute into 1000 by gram molecular weight of solute into weight of solvent in grams. This formula we use for molality, either in elevation in boiling point problems or in depression in freezing point problems. We use this formula for molality. Okay, so this formula I had explained already in the beginning topics. Concentration terms I had explained about molality. Okay, next, how to compare the depression and freezing point of different solutions. So for that, see a point. Delta TF means Delta TF means delta TF means T naught minus TS. You know, this is directly proportional to particle concentration. Already we have discussed RLVP, relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation in the boiling point. This depression in freezing point is also directly proportional to particle concentration. What about TS? Where TS is freezing point of solution. How is it related to particle concentration? It is also directly? No. It is inversely proportional to the particle concentration. Why it is inversely? In the case of elevation in boiling point, both delta TB and TS directly proportional to particle concentration. But in this case, elevation in the boiling point is directly proportional, whereas freezing point of solution is inversely. Why? See once the formula. T naught minus TS. So minus TS is directly. T naught is a constant value. Minus TS is the variable. Minus TS if directly proportional, then TS is inversely proportional. So more depression in freezing point means less freezing point. So see some questions how are asked on this topic. Again, let us take four solutions. Some 0.1 molar glucose, 0.1 molar some magnesium nitrate, 0.321 molar some AlCl3, finally 0.1 molar some K4FeCN6. Okay, these are the given solutions. Now question is, which will have the least delta TF? Delta TF means least depression in freezing point. So for that, first calculate the particle concentration. It is 0.1 because non-dissociating. Particle concentration is 0.1. For this, 0.2 magnesium nitrate, so it is 2. MgNO3 taken twice. Total particles 3. 3 into 0.1, 0.3 molar. It is 0.4 molar, it is 0.5 molar. So, which has the least particle concentration? This one. If particle concentration is least, its depression in freezing point is also least. So, among the given four, which has the least delta TF? First option. Highest delta TF? Fourth option. Now, about freezing point also, some questions will be asked. How? See, among the four, which has the highest freezing point? Highest freezing point means, highest freezing point of solution means least particle concentration. So among the four, which has the least concentration? This one. So 0.1 molar glucose has the, it is the least particle concentration means highest. So 0.1 molar glucose has the highest freezing point. Similarly, this 0.1 molar K4FeCN6 has the least freezing point. Okay, so this is about depression of freezing point. See, how is it determined experimentally? This delta TF is determined experimentally by RAS-CAMFOR method. RAS-CAMFOR method. RAS-CAMFOR method. Okay. In this CAMFOR method, CAMFOR is taken as solvent. CAMFOR is taken as solvent. Because of why camphor only selected as solvent, solid solvent? Why it is selected as solid solvent? Because its KF value is very highest. KF of camphor is, KF of camphor is around 39.7 Kelvin kg mole inverse. because of its highest melting point. Melting point is also high for camphor. So because of its higher melting point, highest KF value, it is used as solvent in RAS camphor method. Okay, this is experimental method for the determination of depression of freezing point. So what we can say that when a non-volatile solute is dissolved in a pure solvent, its vapor pressure decreases, boiling point increases, freezing point decreases. So first one RLVP, second one elevation in the boiling point, third one depression in freezing point.